Hello and welcome to the Fwhip Patreon server. My name is Simple Architect and I'm going to be doing a quick rundown and tutorial of the server. I'm going to be showing you around key features, key things to do and look out for just to help you get started. I'll make it a little bit easier for you, so let's get right into it. So the main thing we're going to be going over today is going to be the survival world, which we're in, plot world, which is creative, the Nether, where to find things and how to navigate the Nether, Frostwatch port, which is our shopping district for the survival world. I'll show you guys how to find land, claim it, and then basically build whatever you want and have fun. So some really important and key things to know are the Discord server for the Fwhip Patreon, the din map, which the server uses for creative and survival. Din map is really important because it will show you in survival the entire map, so you can see where people are building, where things are located.
Wow!
There's markings on the map so you know where things are. Useful in the fact that it shows you where people have and have not built to help you better decide on where you would like to build. Okay, let's talk about survival. The survival world is hard mode difficulty, so you better gear up because you will take a ton of damage from mobs early game. So the way you claim land is you find an area which no one has claimed, and then you will outline the area, preferably in netherrack or any block that you have available at the moment. Place it down, and then essentially you just start building within it. Do note that if you are building directly next to someone else's claim, please try to contact that player, get permission to build right next to them, as that player might be expanding sometime in the future, so they might need room and they might not want you to build next to them for that reason or any other reason they decide to provide to you. There are plenty of public farms on the server, such as the Guardian Farm and the Enderman Farm. Just remember that we are on hard difficulties, so there is a chance you might die. In the survival world, you can break and build pretty much anywhere, but please be respectful of other player builds and do not destroy or grief. You can pretty much build anywhere you want on the server, but if there's already a building there or it's already claimed, common sense, do not build or destroy other players' creations, as that is considered griefing and moderator actions will be taken. I think that covers everything for survival, so let's talk about the plot world. Plot world is the server's creative where you are allowed to build whatever you would like respectfully. By respectfully, I'm implying appropriate builds. As soon as you enter plot world, there will be a rules board to your right with all the commands. Easy to follow, easy to set up. If you have any questions, feel free to ask anyone in chat or on Discord. Wow, we're almost halfway through. All right, let's talk about the Nether. The Nether in survival is the central hub for the server. This is the point for survival where you'll be able to navigate the survival world with ease, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Starting with the colors, each cardinal direction has its own color. I'm pretty sure green is south, black is north, red is east, and whatever is west. The Guardian Farm will be found down the cyan tunnel. That definitely doesn't look terrifying at all. Cool thing to note about the Guardian Farm, if you accidentally drop an item in one of the hoppers, you'll be able to go behind the portal down to this chest and you'll be able to pick it right back up, or not. Just kidding, it takes about a minute for it to actually get into the chest. And down this tunnel, you will have the Enderman Farm. It's gonna be all the way down here until you reach this big grand room. And you're gonna turn right and you're gonna go through the portal.
Hey, you, you're finally awake. You were trying to cross the border, right?
You'll be greeted by this beautiful build. Walk through it, fall down, and you're magically in the end. Alright, let's talk about Frostwatch.
Oh my god! Okay, it's happening! Everybody stay calm!
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay calm! Everybody calm down!
Frostwatch is going to be the shopping district for the server. This is what it looks like on Dinmap. Spawn is right here. This is where you'll spawn onto the server.
Oh my god! Wow! Oh my god!
If you go north, this is Frostwatch port. Basically, you buy and sell things in this area on the server. You can build a shop, you can buy a pre-built shop, or you can rent a shop. It's really up to you. The possibilities are endless. This is how you get to the shopping district through the Nether. You're going to enter in this hub area. Then you're going to go through one of these portals, and it'll take you into a different location inside Frostwatch. Let's say you have some money and you would like to spend it on some things in Frostwatch. Well, don't worry, because I could show you how to do that. Congratulations, you just found diamonds and you would like to spend that hard-earned cash. First, you're going to want to walk around Frostwatch to find the shop that you're looking for. Most shops are labeled. Then you're going to go inside. If you see something you like, you're going to buy it. It's an honor system, so you're going to switch out the item with the amount of diamonds that is required, and then you're just going to take that item and you're done. Now, let's say you found a spot where you would like to build a shop. Feel free to build a shop. Just remember that Frostwatch is medieval and Nordic themes, so try to keep the themes relevant. Nothing crazy or insane that doesn't belong. If you have any questions, there are rule boards and informational boards scattered around Frostwatch for you to read. So the way to unlock chests and shulkers for players to open, you're going to type in the command slash unlock, and then you're going to right click that chest or shulker to unlock the item, and it's reverse to lock the item. You're going to type in slash lock and then right click that shulker or chest to lock that chest or shulker. There is a sewers underneath Frostwatch, which is kind of a black market area. Just be careful you don't fall in. Under here you have a really large selection of items for you to purchase. Ooh, I almost forgot about fast travel. Fast travel on the server is a way for you to travel from the center of the map spawn to pretty much the border of the map, 9,000 to 8,000 blocks away. Instead of walking there in the overworld or traversing through the Nether or flying there with Elytra, you can simply fast travel to a location. So you are further away from everyone who joined the server earlier than you. Since it's getting a little crowded, you now have more room around the map for you to build. You just simply press the button on one of the ships that take you to different locations around the map. And if you want to get back to the fast travel area near Frostwatch porch and spawn, you just simply press the same button on the same ship and it will just take you straight back. If for some reason you're a psychopath, we do have actual roads on the server that go in every cardinal direction, northeast, south, and west, that go all the way 10,000 blocks to the world border, which was all done in survival, made by hand for God knows what reason. So yeah, there's another way to travel if you want. We do have a mesa biome where you are free to mine sand and terracotta. Don't worry about destroying the environment. It's its own separate world and it does get reset every once in a while for this purpose. And most of the players on the server use the Fwhip Patreon texture pack. You're not required to, but if you want to get the full experience of most of the builds on the server, it's highly recommended. And that essentially wraps up the tutorial video. There's probably a lot of things I missed and didn't include. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them down below in the comments or on Discord or on the server. There are plenty of friendly and helpful people on the server that are willing to answer your questions as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it.
Oh no!
Oh, no.
Oh,